Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the words of the Beis HaLevi's Maimah HaBitachon, a new chapter today, Yud Aleph number 11, entitled Tzipisa LeYeshua. Did you wait and hope in anticipation of the Yeshua of the salvation? We'll see a chiddush, a new way that the Beis HaLevi will explain this. Im his chazakta bebitachon ba'Hashem. Did you strengthen yourself in bitachon in Hashem? And listen to this beautiful way in which the Beis HaLevi explains a well-known statement of Chazal. Once that we've explained how it is not appropriate for a person to trust and rely upon any human being, any creature in this world. As we said, we should put all of our faith in the Ribbono Shel'olam. Rather, a person has to place all of his confidence, all of his trust, and his reliance in Hashem. Ki hu echad me'amitzvah shebatoira. As the Beis HaLevi has been explaining up until this point, this is an actual mitzvah that we have in the Torah. To be b'teach b'Hashem, to trust in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to put your faith in Hashem, not to be sidetracked in this world and believe in other people and other things that they're going to help you, but rather recognize clearly with a vision that is so pure that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the only one that is going to rescue you and save you and help you through every situation that you are in. U'bishas hadin shoyelin loy. At the time that a person leaves this world after 120 years and they are standing before the Holy Tribunal and he's going to be asked the following question, Tzipisa LeYeshua, did you wait for the salvation? Now the simple explanation of this question, which is a Gemara, Chazal are telling us a person's going to be asked. You lived in a world of galus, of exile. You lived in a world where the Beis HaMikdash was destroyed for 2,000 years. You lived in a world where the voice or the prayers of Mashiach have been on the lips of Klal Yisrael for thousands of years already, hoping and waiting and yearning with patience that any day, Achakel lo yawait, he's Sheyovo, he's going to come. Asks the Gemara, you who leaves this world after 120 years and saw the triviality of this world and knew that we were missing the main thing, which is a Beis HaMikdash, which is the Shechina coming down, which is HaKadosh Baruch Hu's presence being well known. You know that we were lacking Mashiach. Tzipisa LeYeshua. Were you waiting every single day? Were you yearning that Mashiach is going to come? Were you waiting for the Geula Shleima, the ultimate redemption, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to gather in Klal Yisrael from the Arba Kanfais Ha'aretz, the four corners of the world? Were you waiting for that? That will be a question that we are asked because it will show that we realize that this world is not what it's all about. It's really about a much grander existence when the world will come to Shleimus to fruition and Klal Yisrael will be deemed as the Ama Nivcha, the chosen nation, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu's presence will be known throughout the land. He'll be the Melech Al Kol Ha'aretz. He'll be the king over the entire universe. Did you wait for that? That's the question. That's the way that Rashi explains that question in the Gemara. However, says the Beis HaLevi, a chiddush, a beautiful insight. Perush, what is the question? Did you await for the salvation? Perush, it means imchika liyeshua v'loi nisyayesh mimena. Did you wait for your personal salvation in life? And you never despaired that HaKadosh Baruch Hu could bring you a salvation from whatever it is that you are going through in your life. And you strengthen yourself in your trust in Hashem. In every new detail, new situation, in everything that came upon you and arose upon you in your lifetime, you were mechazik, you strengthened yourself, and you realized Hashem, Hu Elokim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the one that is going to rescue me and save me from that which I am going through right now. Says the Beis HaLevi, we'll have to speak about this much more tomorrow, but says the Beis HaLevi, an amazing idea that should give a lot of us chizuk and strength. We recognize up until this point that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the source of all salvation in this world. He is the source of all bracha, He is the source of all hardship, He is the source of all goodness, He is the source of all curse. Everything that we have in our lives is coming from the Ribbono Shel Olam. But a Yid, a Jew, is never allowed to despair for a second in his situation in life. And therefore, at the end of 120 years, when we go up to Shemayim and they ask us the following question, Tzipisili Yeshua, were you waiting for the salvation in your life? Did you recognize that at any minute HaKadosh Baruch Hu could change things around? At any second, the salvation, your freedom is going to come. The situation that you find yourself being in so oppressive, so suffocating, so difficult. Did you think in every single second that HaKadosh Baruch Hu can come down to your life and He can change things around and lift you up from the trash heaps and the dumps that you find yourself in? That's what a Yid has to think about in this world. We're not by ourselves. We don't trust in people. We don't trust in ourselves. Chalila, we are so inconsistent in our actions. We are so fragile in our belief. We can't trust in ourselves. But we are asked, do you trust in Hashem? And did you believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu? Did you rely upon Hashem? And did you never give up hope that any second that a person is going through a difficult challenge in their life, HaKadosh Baruch Hu can bring the Yeshua, Hashem can bring your personal salvation. Have a wonderful, inspiring day that is filled with bitachon, where we don't misyayesh, we don't despair and give up, but rather we believe, be'amuna shleima, complete faith in Hashem, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu can do anything that He wants to bring the salvation personally to every person in all of Klal Yisrael. Have a wonderful day.